You think it's wise splitting up?
Without a working tricorder, we have to cover as much ground as possible. Stay in constant contact. We'll use our communicators as homing beacons. If anything comes up, anything, you give me a call.
Agreed.
We'll search until dark.
Be careful, Lieutenant.
Boldly go.
I found the ship. A complete wreck. But from the markings, I would say it's Klingon.
Klingon? I see. What about the crew?
The ship couldn't hold more than two occupants and nobody's home. It's a good bet we have some Klingon company.
Understood. Let's regroup as soon as possible. I'll home in on your signal.
Keep your eyes open. Run out.
So much for the mighty Federation.
Humanoid life form. Bearing 325, Mark 7.
Honoring the treaty between the Klingon Empire and the Federation?
Well, if I wasn't, we wouldn't be having this conversation right now, would we?
Excellent. I like you, human.
Do you have a name? Do you prefer I give you a name?
My name is Krennic, Imperial Scientist.
I'm Daniel Sagan, geophysicist from the starship Hannibal. And why don't you tell me how you ended up here on Beta 9?
It was a navigational error.
I see. It was my understanding that scientists pursue truth above all else. Then again, I never met a Klingon scientist before. Not exactly a warlike occupation.
Then it is apparent that you do not understand the Klingon science. We are the instruments used by the Empire to expand. Without us, there would be no interstellar glory.
You sound bitter.
We do not share the same emotional weaknesses that plague you humans.
Krennic, I'll be honest. I don't know what's going on here, but I'll spell out a few things. You're in Federation space. And navigational errors aside, Starfleet intelligence is going to have a lot of questions for you. And once they're done, you're going to be handed back over to the Klingon Council very publicly. And you can tell me what they'll do to you.
I am not on a spy mission. I am being hunted down for what I know.
Well, what do you know? And who's hunting you down? Another Klingon.
Yes. But he is not like me. He represents the very reason why I'm here. It is not by accident. I crossed the neutral zone to contact the Federation.
You broke the treaty and risked war. Why?
It is not a tale for someone of such low rank. But I will be dead soon. And this information has to get out.
Just tell your story, Klingon.
Our empire made peace with the Federation because we knew civil war was imminent. Soon after, it became a reality.
We had heard rumors, but nothing substantial.
It is far worse than you suspect. The Klingon race, as you know it, will soon no longer exist.
Wait a minute, this isn't making any sense. You're telling me Klingons are wiping out other Klingons?
I do not have the time nor the energy to explain everything to you, human.
Then I don't believe you.
What do you know of Klingon history?
I'm a scientist, so Klingon history is not my field of expertise.
Very well. Our real history began millions of years ago, when the Klingon race developed into two very different species. Both fought for survival and dominance.
That's like on ancient Earth when Cro-Magnon and Neanderthal man both lived in the same time period.
Yes, except in our case, both species failed to wipe each other out. Both flourished on our home world, claiming a piece of the planet for themselves. These regions became known as... The closest translation in your language would be the Northern and Southern Provinces. The Northern Klingons, later classified as Muk Klingons, developed cranial ridges and great physical strength. The Southern species, classified as the S, remained externally unchanged, but mentally superior. However, by the time Kalis arrived, the Vess were all but gone.